the biggest contributor to global warming in Kenya right now is the public transport sector.
At least 4 million passenger trips are made every day, but most of them using diesel.
There's a lot of congestion on the roads, which means there's a lot of pollution. Electric vehicles make sense. 90% of the Kenyan grid is renewable at the moment. We have enough surplus of electricity to power our grid and to be able to charge and support electric vehicles in Kenya.
Nairobi and Kenya and Africa is geared up to electric mobility. That's our mission, to make sure that we electrify Africa's transport system. Rome is headquartered in Nairobi, Kenya, next to the national park. It gives us an inspiration of building a cleaner, safer environment for both wild animals and also human beings. We produce electric buses and electric motorcycles.
Motorcycles are used by basically everyone here in Kenya.
So the cheapest way to move from one point to another in Nairobi is using the boda bodas. So these are the commuter motorcycles.
It's how we get food to our local market, to the nearest bus station or much deeper rural areas. So many people use it to be able to have a source of income that's reliable and stable. But there are approximately around 2 to 3 million motorcycles on the road, and the number keeps growing.
Every year we see about 600,000 motorcycles being registered annually. And these motorcycles are fossil powered, which means they have carbon emissions. That only means that we are getting to a very sensitive point in Nairobi where pollution is at a new high. Every year, the carbon footprint grows. Electric vehicles are better in many ways. They have zero emissions, cheaper to maintain. When it comes to the cost of fueling an electric vehicle, already we are over 50% cheaper.
With electric motorcycles, we can be completely reliant on the electricity produced internally here locally, because already our grid is renewable.
So targeting the boda boda sector means that we are able to drive change from the grassroots. We give you a charger and a battery that you can move around with and plug into any normal power outlet. Makes it easier for our users to be able to recharge anywhere, to be able to replenish and to not lose any mileage. We also have a rental battery model where if you don't have time to wait for the charging, you can just swap and get a different battery that you can run with and then come back and pick your battery at the end of your business.
So the design of the Romeo all started with the belief and concept that we can build a product that will last for a long period of time. There are very few products that were designed for Kenyans in mind. Our unique topography in sub-Saharan Africa means that we have a very different set of climatic conditions. We have different terrains, from sand to rocky terrain. We've designed our product from scratch. Every single component on that bike has been designed right here in-house by engineers here in Rome.
So we make two types of buses, specifically designed and developed for the African continent. Our vehicles are designed here and also made here. And why this is important is so anybody who wants a spare part doesn't have to ship it from abroad, but can access that spare part there and there.
They are cheaper, more robust, and people who experience our products immediately fall in love with them.
We are providing solutions to Nairobi, to Kenya, to Africa, for passengers to be on safe, reliable, very sustainable means, and to make sure that it's very convenient. The entire transport system has to be harmonized, work in one. Charging infrastructure is very critical in making sure that public transport is organized. It will revolutionize Africa's public transport system. We started off with Nairobi, and we're also looking into other cities in Mombasa, Kisumu, East Africa, Uganda, Kigali, Tanzania. So with these products, we're able to support an entire public transport system.
Kenya is ahead when it comes to working towards becoming a green economy. Rome has already done the work. We have done our proof of concept to make the electric vehicle adoption a reality. But right now, we need stakeholders to come into play. And that means the government has to come up with policies, tax incentives. We need to have local manufacturing. We need to build local capacity.
We need to be in the forefront. Right here, we can develop with climate solutions in mind.